Greetings and welcome back once again. This is Solonomics 101 and my name is Imuna Yisrael, recent author of Angry Black Woman Syndrome Revisited. If you don't know what that is, feel free to check the link out. It's a very interesting take a look at the stereotype or the syndrome of the angry black woman as it relates to society today. But let's get into the topic for today. Today I wanted to talk about commerce. You know, there's an interesting quote out there that says, if you change the way you look at things, the way you look at things begin to change. I'll say it again. If you change the way you look at things, the way you look at things begin to change. I know it sounds like wordplay and word switch, but reality is, when I say the word commerce, what's the first thing that comes to your mind? What if I said, even though you don't own a physical business or an online business or anything of that nature, you still participate in commerce every day? And I'm not talking about necessarily with money. When you look up the word commerce, the very first definition that you will find is not of goods and services or products and things of that nature. The first definition is social intercourse, interchange of ideas, opinions, or sentiments. So in reality, you're watching this video, we are engaging in commerce. That sounds wild. You don't believe me? Pick up your dictionary and check it out. When you have a conversation with people, you are engaging in commerce because you are exchanging ideas, sentiments, and opinions. Now, that's interesting. I'm going to let that simmer for about 2 seconds. Yeah, simmer. Now, if you go into interaction with people and you come out feeling broke emotionally, yeah, you just had a bad business with someone. You understand what I'm saying? If you come out like, that person is messed up, that was a social exchange or intercourse of ideas, feelings, and sentiments, and that person is bad business. We say this in kind of a euphemistic kind of way, in a way in which we jest and speak, but in reality, this is also one of the working definitions of the word. So what does that have to do with you and I? If our ideas, sentiments, and opinions are commerce, then we should be making sure that our ideas, sentiments, and opinions are good. Now, for instance, if you go to certain stores and you keep buying their clothes, as soon as you buy it, rip up, it's not good, it's cheap, what's going to happen? Either you're going to say, it's not worth it, I'm not going to go to that store because they don't have good products. The reason why certain people excel, and I'm not talking about racism, things of that nature, I'm just talking about person-to-person interaction. I'm talking about in your family. I'm talking about, you know, necessarily on your job. I'll get into resources in a minute, but as we relate to commerce, I'm just talking about if you walked up to somebody sitting on a bench, either you're going to have a good conversation or a bad conversation. Either you're going to have something to take away, or you're just going to feel like somebody took away something from you. So this is, on for me, the base level as it relates to human beings, one to another. Yeah. So every time we interact with one another, remember, you are engaging in commerce. I know you have been taught that money has to be there, product has to be there, but the exchange indicates that there is commerce. Now, that third definition of commerce, the second definition of commerce is the exchange or buying or selling of commodities on a large scale involving transportation from place to place. That's the definition we're kind of used to. Yes, so basically, that third definition, let that be homework. Go check out what that is, because some people engage in a whole lot of commerce on that third definition and end up real broke. But as we continue on, I'm talking about business today and commerce. And again, if we change the way we look at things, the way we look at things begin to change. The world has taught us, media has taught us, that only certain opinions, thoughts, and sentiments are more important than others. And because we have bought into this thought process, we devalue others who we don't feel are in that space, that operate in where they're more important. Now, how do you make your thoughts, ideas, and sentiments more valuable? You are the one who is responsible for that. Not when somebody comes along and says, hey, I'm going to put your value on you. You have to put your own value on your thoughts, ideas, and sentiments. And not in a narcissistic type of way, like, oh, you know, I'm the bomb, and just because I said it, that's what it be. No, you're going to want to make sure that you are substantiating your thoughts, ideas, and opinion on something that is factual. You know what I'm saying? Or it's not things that you just make up, you know, I had a dream and you just jump up. You have to take a look and you have to begin to educate yourself, not for the purposes of merely working as a cog in the system, but educate yourself so that you will become a more well-rounded person. Have conversation or engage in intellectual, how you doing? Intellectual commerce one to another. Intellectual commerce. Think about it. All right, let's go on. Now, I looked up business, okay? The first definition, contrary to popular belief, doesn't necessarily have to be with opening a storefront and bam, I'm here. Business, the first definition in this Merriam-Webster is role or function. And it comes from the word busyness or purposeful activity. Purposeful activity. Meaning, just like I said, if you want your intellectual commerce to be to where it is valued, not just as you exchange it for monetary gain or life, but as it relates to you living a more fulfilled life, you have to go about the business of having purposeful activity. You can go ahead and read the rest of the definitions. As we know, there's some, you know, a particular field of endeavor, commercial or mercantile activity. My point of this conversation is that when we hear words like commerce, business, resources, purchase, they're not only related to material items or services, they relate to you, the person who is your own business owner, even if you never open a shop. And how you feel at the end of your day determines if you had a good business day or a bad business day. So let's talk about business. You ever heard somebody say, man, that's none of your business? Does that, when they say that, does that mean you're actually doing, you know, business where you bought something or sold something tangible from them? No, they're talking about this purposeful activity that I'm engaging, my intellectual ideas, opinions, and sentiments is none of your concern. That's none of your business. So we use it in conversation, not realizing that we are the most valuable resource as it relates. Now, I'm gonna go over to resource now. Resources is an interesting word. And some people right now, you know, I've seen some of the comments which are so interesting. I'm going to talk about that in another episode. But, you know, if we spew nothing but negativity, that means we have products, ideas, meaning sentiments, or opinions that are necessarily based or not really manufactured well. They're manufactured in our own thought process, not really based on facts. And so oftentimes you hear people calling people out of their name, but it's not really based on anything they know for certainty. And I'll go into that in another video to show you that if we had more accountability for the way in which we refer to one another. For instance, if someone goes into, and I believe a famous star right now is about to go to court and try to sue someone for libel and slander. And that means that you're holding people accountable for what comes out of their mouth. And if more people were accountable for what comes out of their mouth, their intellectual commerce, just the same way if somebody sells you some bad vitamins or some bad whatever, you're going to go to court. In the same way, if somebody is fraudulently giving information, or if somebody is defaming someone or bearing false witness, that also needs to come into account. And what that would do is make people think twice or three times before they open up their mouth and spew falsehood. So to produce is to offer view or notice, to give birth to or rise to. So we are all producers. We are producers of thoughts, ideas, and opinions, of which we then use to engage in commerce. The first definition. So I know sometimes the thought is like on how I'm gonna get this money, how I'm gonna get this money, how I'm gonna get this house, how I'm gonna get this car, all of which cannot go with you at the end of the day. And remember, this is Solonomics 101, so I'm coming from a different point of view. And I'm not saying that you don't need those things in this third dimension. What I am saying is, if at the end of the day, in layman's term, you're just like a terrible person, or at the end of the day, you don't manage your interpersonal relationships very well, then you won't be that wealthy. You won't be that rich. You have to hire people, if you even have the money, to take care of you, because people will not be compelled out of love because you didn't invest in that area. So basically, we are all producers. My question to you today is, what in the world are you producing? You understand what I'm saying? Are you producing hate? Are you producing love? Are you producing jealousy? Are you producing envy? Are you producing idiocy? Are you producing ignorance? Are you in producing intellectual conversation and commerce? Or are you just making bad products with a whole lot of toxins and poisons in them, and you better not buy your children that stuff because it's filled with lead and might cause some issues? I'm saying that if we change the way we look at things, the way we look at things begin to change, and all terms have a physical type of way in which we can relate to them, and also a spiritual way in which we can relate to them. So I wanted to say, what am I saying? Words like merchant, produce, commerce, business, resources. It's one thing about the resources. Now check it out. Well, how does Muna know what she's talking about? Maybe just Muna is crazy. So let's just look at the world. Say you wanted to go into a big corporation, right? And you wanted them to hire you because you really needed a job. Not realizing that you were the resource. Not realizing that you were bringing the value to that company. So you go up in there, and where do you go? They say, hey man, take your resume to HR. Maybe I'm a little bit dated because now they just be like, send it on the email. But nonetheless, you send it to HR at bigcorporation.com. HR stands for what? Human resources. Human resources. You're very important. But if you don't know that, and you rent out your ideas, sentiments, labor, energy, to get what you perceive, what the world has taught us is more important, which is monetary gain, then you kind of may spend your whole life not realizing that you are the resource. And if you invest in you, the resource, by bettering your ideas, sentiments, and opinions, then you will have more power in which to have this exchange. Lastly, there's a thought out there that says if you do something for 10,000 hours, you will be considered a master in that field or in that subject. So mastery, if you look at 10,000 hours, I kind of tried to do the breakdown, that equals to 416.6 days. But if you are not going to do it 24 hours a day, and say you do it 8 hours a day for 5 days a week, that would equal a little bit over four and a half years for you to master something. Now think about your life and think about what you have been doing 8 hours a day and 5 days a week for whatever the time period. There's a thought that everybody's an expert at something. Sometimes you could be the expert at nothing. We have expert video game players. We have expert Facebook watchers. We have expert, professions like doctors and lawyers, and they weren't born doctors and lawyers. They increased their value, their intellectual property, by investing in themselves and by, in return, getting a large amount of return on their investment. I say that to say, change the way you look at things, and the way you look at things will begin to change. So if you don't like your position, and you think that it's a business is necessarily going to change it, because let me tell you something, if you go into a business that you don't feel purposeful in, that business can begin to feel like a prison. Even if you're your own boss. I'm just a person who has, from the age of 12, loved entrepreneurship. I'm what they call a serial entrepreneur. I just like the thought of developing a product, bringing it to market, and seeing how it does. There's just people like that. Their brain works like that. But remember that if you go into something that you don't feel purpose in, eventually you're going to want to let it go. So spend the time in increasing your intellectual commerce, your spiritual commerce, your commerce as it relates to you as a being, so that you can live a more fulfilled life. So until next time, my name is Emuna Yisrael. As the baby creeps up on me right about now, I'm a real mommy, see? I'll talk to you later and have a great day. One.